Okay, I'm back in edit mode on this page, and what I want to go over now is one final option on image insert, and I think this is going to be applicable as well for file attachments. I'm actually going to just create a little section down here at the bottom and call it downloads. If let's say I want to insert an image of Dr. Austin from the previous example, and I want to make that available for someone to download, but you know, maybe a higher resolution image. If I pick And again, I'm going to go with the 150 pixel image just because that's what I have in here. But if I click on link to file and insert that where I left my cursor down here at the bottom, basically what I'm going to get is the option of just simply putting a file path in there for an image. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight that because again, the file name is it doesn't really mean anything. And I'm going to highlight it in such a way that I can type over it and keep the link embedded in there. And I'm going to write out something or type out something like download portrait of Dr. Curtis Austin. And then just parenthetically, I'm going to put in there what the file type is so that I can let somebody know. And I just kind of from this is really not a big deal either way, but I'm going to unlink that just because it's, I don't know, it looks a little bit cleaner to me from my perspective, but it doesn't matter one way or the other. If I save that, though, let's see what happens. I'll be able to click on that. And because Drupal will actually allow us to put in an image up to 8 megabytes, like I said, we can upload a much larger file image, a high resolution image, if somebody needed that. So that's an option for dealing with images. If I go back and edit, file attachments are going to work much the same way. Now I'm gonna throw a little caveat at the end about accessibility issues, but there is a file attachment field. It's called attachment upload, and it works really the same way. I'm going to browse, and I'm going to jump over to my desktop, and I'm going to find a spreadsheet file, and I'm going to upload that, and I'm just going to scroll back up to where my text is in my body field, and I'm going to move this down, and I'm going to insert. So basically what I'm doing is creating a section at the bottom where you can put file attachments that you might want to have. Okay, and again, kind of puts out that long file path. I don't actually have to highlight the whole thing. I just have to have my cursor on there. When I click on that, I can actually get the link file path, and I'm simply going to copy that. And this is just an alternate way of doing what I did with the image of Dr. Austin, where I highlighted and typed over the link. I'm simply going to delete this. Now remember, I've copied the, I've done a Control C or an Apple C, and I've copied that URL. So I'm going to say download spreadsheet of map data. Okay, and I'm going to again put in parentheses that it's an Excel file or something to that effect. Again, so I know what you're letting users know what you're clicking on. Now I'm going to highlight that. I'm going to go back up to the link properties field. I'm going to paste that. I did a Control V or an Apple V to paste that back in and insert it. And so that's essentially two different ways to do the same thing, either typing over the link that's embedded or simply selecting it and copying it to your pasteboard and then reinserting it back over what you've typed. And again, when I click on that, I'll get the option to open a spreadsheet. Okay, so let's stop here and I'll actually talk about the accessibility issues on the next video.